Hello everybody, and welcome back to the next episode in our brand new Let's Play of a Drug Dealer Simulator. At this moment in time, we managed to get up to level 4 in a bit. We need to get to level 6, which is the main goal of this episode. Once we get to level 6, we'll unlock the Ecstasy. We'll also unlock Emma, who's in the market stall area as well. On top of that, we'll also be able to then unlock the next area in the map. Now, the main plan, as I've said before, we are going to go for Kenji. To get Kenji, we have to have our exposition really high, but we don't have to do that till level 20. So we've got a lot to do to get there. Hopefully it shouldn't take too long. Let's just see what order we got coming in. So we got 4 amp. Make that 6 amp. 8 amp. And 5. So can we do that? Have we got 5 grams? Yep. And we've got 8 amp. Perfect. So what time is it now? Okay, it's not quite the right time of day. So what we will do, we will go ahead and change it. So yeah, level 6 we unlock stink. Our marketplace is unlocked, and then we'll do the next part. So let's fast forward it until it is night time.
Внимание, 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 всем гостям граждан, комендантский час начнется через 60 минут, повторяю.
Tam kurwa, bo i tam takie doksy naprawiają, że ja jebę. Takie rzeczy tam pukają, że ja bym tym się wstydził kibel kurwa przyczyścić, nie? Dobra, ale ten...
Right, okay, there we go. So we've got those orders out the way. That was a nice, simple, quick run. What I'm looking for is I'm looking to get to level 5 and level 6 by the end of this episode. And then we can start mixing our first batch of amp. Because we're going to need the crusher. Oh, there's an order come in. And that would allow us to do the sugar and ibuprofen because we need to grind them down. 8 grams, so now we're starting to get the better quantities coming in from each person. 5 and 3. There we go. But I would like to say, while we just doing this bit. Thank you to everyone that has been subscribing and liking and commenting on the video so far. I didn't think we're going to get the response we have done, and it's been great. We are going to continue my other playthrough that we're doing, called After the Endgame, which is where we're actually getting to the Villa side of things. This game is going to concentrate on Kenji. So as I said before, with Kenji, we need to get to level 20, make sure we've got a high exposition ranking. From what I believe, it's around about there we're going to have to get once we get to before level 20. So when we hit level 20 and unlock Kenji, we're not going to get Balena instead. Oh, good goal. It's about to go out. I've got another order come in. He wants 4 amp. Perfect. The first drug that we're going to mix is we are going to be doing the, is referred to in the community as the blue amp recipe. That doesn't have any Viagra in it. That'll be the sweet amp, and finally when LSD is unlocked, we can then do the super amp, which I have tested off camera, and we've had no overdoses on that. Unfortunately, we have had a couple of ODs from a different drug. One of the original crystal meth. Meth Bang, as it was called. Killed one of the clients. So we're going to refine that recipe, because I think it was because the fentanyl that was used was 2 grams of pure fent. We didn't cut it with anything. But when they become addicts, then you're in trouble with it. So, there we go. 5 and 3, so that's the 8. There we go, we're now up to level 6. Level 5. Perfect. There we go, so we can now get our first dealer. And also, we are going to increase the pockets now. Normally, we should be doing Salesman and Quick Learner, but what I've learnt playing this game, the more pockets we have, the better. Because eventually we'll have to go in the sewers. And we'll have to have the factory key. So we're going to need 4 or 5 pockets at least to be able to do that without keep taking stuff out of ourselves. Also, if we're doing runs with drugs, this game encourages you to have smaller backpacks so you don't get seen by the cops. Much longer than the day, not until we got 2 or 3 hours. Okay, we might be able to make two or three more drops. Put the cash back in there, so 696. I think Eddie doesn't want that much, does he? Deliver cash for cartel. And how much is he saying? He wants 240. That's perfect. So we can do that, and then we can order the next quantity during the day. Right, let's fast forward again. We've only got 1 ping at the minute, so we're going to have to just make do with that for now. Shady. East Old Town, he wants 2. Okay, fine. And what we could do also do as well, because we need to go east. How much did Eddie want? He wanted 240. Okay, so let's put 240 in our pocket. Or as close as we can. That's something else I wish this game would allow us to do, is put how much money we want to take. But hopefully that's something that will be implemented into the next game. Now I heard the cops somewhere. No, oh, I ping right near daylight. Would you believe it? There's Eddie. There's his money sorted. Because we're now level 5, we can order more product yet again. And we also know it's a long way off, but before we unlock the end game, and we make sure we buy as much product from Eddie as possible, when the endgame launches, you then can't order from him. So then we can have a massive stockpile and not have to pay him back. So it's free cash, basically. Shady. But that's not for ages. Wants 4 grams. Oh, I've got another ping as well. Perfect. Should be able to do that. Shady. So 4 grams. Yep. Ah, there you go. Perfect. Our first dealer.
Looky here, you've just hired your first dealer. Congrats. Dealers order the dope just like any other clients, but a lot more, progressively. The thing is that they pay up after they distribute, so take that into consideration.
And that's really good for us. Now, the only downside is we don't get safes until we end Sector C, so that's... So we're going to do the old way of getting money, but eventually we'll be able to use the safes. And I have found one or two little tricks we can do for the safe. There we go, 4. Perfect. How far off are we from level 6? Oh, we're going to have to do some daytime deliveries just to get us rolling. So how much have we got left? 15 and 5, so we can order some more. Oh, new order. He wants some as well. Perfect. 2 dealers. That's what we want to see. East Old Town would like 3. Yeah, we can do that one. And we're very quick. Get the extra bonus in for nighttime delivery. But we've got to be very quick. We're going to make it. Oh, East Old Town. Go, 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 go. It's going to be tight. 3G. Oh, done it. Oh, there you go. Obviously about... 10 seconds or something to spare. And I'll just stay here, wait for it to flash, and then we're back to police hours. So in that one night, we have gone up literally by about one level. So to get to level 6, we will get most of that done during the daytime. Right, let's go back in. Order the next batch we're going to need from Eddie. Shady. And let's see, how much can we order now? 470, so it's double what we had before. So we've only got 5 grams there, so let's make it 15 to start with. Amp, we are going to be doing 20 gram batches, so let's try 40. And we've still got spare. Okay, so let's put in 40. 10 over. That's fine. Let's go down to 38. Perfect. We could also at this point buy Pipcoin and do the balance. So I tell you what, I know you lose a little bit of money. Pipcoin's useless once Eddie has left the whole game, so let's buy some Pipcoin. And all we need is 10. So you have to buy 180's worth. Fine. Balance it with Pipcoin. Order. That's it. Cool. And that's going to take a lot longer now to come to us. In fact, okay, 4 hours. Now we've also got a new dealer. Sorry, a new order. And they want 2 grams. So now we will be doing deals during the day, and luckily that takes out the MJ. So let's save what we're doing as well now, because I don't want to lose too much progress. So now we've got to head all the way to the old marketplace, and it should be behind the shop. Yep. So we went around furniture shop. so it is 2 grams. I'm not sure we won't get as much XP as previously needed, but when you're starting out, the best thing to do is just get as much product sold so you get more orders coming in. Otherwise, you just gotta keep waiting and waiting for night time. I don't know about you, but waiting for night time does take a while in your first hideout. When we unlock a second hideout, then obviously we'll be able to speed it up more than times 11, but for now it's taking absolutely ages. Also, by waiting, we can actually get more orders during the day. Our respect is going up in other areas, so we're going to get more clients appearing. When we get downtown unlocked, then we're at the races, really, with money. Although, to be fair with our dealers at the moment, if we keep doing our dealers as quickly as possible... Oh, goodness, I should get a payment as well. Let's have a look. How much is that one worth? Nice. So social security happens on a regular basis as well, so it's going to bolster up. So what do they want? Oof, 18 grams, 10 grams, 4, 2, and 2. So now we're going to rank up very quickly. Now we're getting our dealers on it. I think the craziest I had, I unlocked Belena. And I think we had, in my other playthrough, something like 200 grams worth. Which was just absolutely ludicrous. Took ages to get it, and we ended up with nearly like £4,000 from that, dollars from that. So dealers are the way to go. The best dealers to get will be Sector C and Sector B. Sector C like to order heroin and cocaine. Sector B also like to order them, as well as having marijuana, the ecstasy, meth as well. So you really end up with a really nice amount. Oh, there's the cops. We can also hand out free drugs, but we won't do that until we have the recipe mixer unlocked. Sorry, crusher. Oh, there's two lots of cops. Wow. You always get these weird experiences happening in the game. So they're going to go that way. Good. Are those two going to go straight ahead? Nope, they're going the same route. Interesting. I've got to be careful because I want to get... Right, let's pick up those two bags. Let's run it down the middle of our house. I'm not sure, since the latest update, whether they've actually changed the paths of the cops. But they do have a weirder route now. I have seen them walking through some of our shortcuts. Which is always quite awkward. So, move that into there. So we've got 45 grams of product. Perfect. We're going to have to make another order. MJ pretty quick. In fact, before we do any more, can we deliver the cash? 470. Yes, we can. Now, are there any orders for East or West? West, West, West. Cool. Which is just outside our house. And then we've got East as well. 2, 4. And then it is 18, 28, 32 grams. So we've got 2 twos. So it's a 4, 18, a 10. 4. 18, no more 10. Just check. Yep, just about fits into our backpack. We will save the game now before we go out. Every 5 minutes we can save the game, just to be on the safe side. Make sure nothing untoward happens. Oh, that's really nice. Our two dealers and our customer are right here, so that's really nice. So, 2 times 2. Boom. You want 10. You want 18. And there's level 6. Perfect. So we now have ecstasy available. As you saw, we had over 1,000 there. So now let's do the stealth, because we don't want the cops to see us as often as we want. Thank you ever so much for watching. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave your comments down in the section. I do read all of them. And anything that you want to know or ask, just put in there, and I'll be able to answer it for you. But thank you ever much for watching. I've been DC Gaming. Thank you, and I'll see you again next time.